Hello, 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 you guys. I do want to apologize for not posting about what time I would come live today. Actually, fair warning, this whole week is going to be really crazy for me. So I didn't want to tell you guys a set time if I didn't know for sure I'd be able to come on. So I've got some free time. I wanted to be here. And this week, I wanted to talk more about the mental game that happens with your business. A lot of people forget that aspect. I did. I went through like getting everything perfect, getting all the right systems and, software, using the right website, like getting all of this stuff together. And I didn't realize that my mentality or my mental health would actually make or break my business. So I went through a lot of ups and downs until I really got that stabilized, and then I've been able to consistently grow. Now, I mean, I'm not saying I was like, uneven or something. That's not my point. But my point is when business was good, business was really good. But when business was low, business was low. And so, I want to help you guys with your mental game. I want to give you guys a few kind of ideas of things that you can journal about and really work through to make sure that your mind is right when it comes to business. So, the first thing I really, and so I'll do like a series of these, okay? I'm not going to do them all at once. That'll be a lot of work for you guys to come up with. But the first thing that I really want to talk to you guys about is success. So, what is your idea of success? What does successful mean to you? And I want you guys to write this out. So, what is successful? What will it take? What does it look like? If somebody says something about successful, what image pops to your head? I had a client last week tell me that, like, this, like, short, like, stocky guy, big round belly, cigar, top hat. Like suit kind of wearing guy, like that is what she sees when she thinks success. So what is it, right? And I want you to really write it down. What do you see success as right now? And then I want you to rewrite your story. So for her, right, she doesn't fit in that idea, right? She's a young lady, and so she had to go in and she had to rewrite that story. I want you to rewrite your success story and to go at it in a way that it is tangible. So talk about, big goals. What does success mean overall? But what are some small things that will make you feel successful as well? Success, it'll vary, but maybe it's like getting your first client will give you that feeling of success. Making a consistent income will get you that idea of success. Making more money each month gives you this sense of success. Being able to consistently bring in 5K, 10K, whatever it is. And I want you to really dive into this and write out a picture. Because it's not always just about money. I know for me, success was having time to spend with my daughter. Success was making my own plan, my own schedule, and to still be able to pay for everything, right? Like I'm not working 40 plus hours for somebody else. I'm working my time, my schedule, and all of my bills are paid, and I'm happy, and I'm doing what I love. Another thing that I viewed success as was being able to go to the grocery store and not have to like check my bank account, right? I could just go buy groceries and never think about it. So I want you guys to really write out those tangible things to you that will make you feel successful. And I want you guys, the last part of this is to do your own research. So if you're in a certain industry, I would like you to focus on that. But you can look at success across the board, but find people that are similar to you. So if you're a network marketer, you don't have to look even just within your company, but look throughout network marketing. Look at your company, sure. But who is maybe successful that is close to your age, or maybe they had success at your age? Who is, a female, a male? Like, what are those similar demographics that you guys can kind of go through and find them to be successful? And I want you to pay attention. Like, if you get on YouTube, you should save these in a playlist of like successful people or something. And I want you to listen to their story because that's what's most powerful. If you can find their testimony, where did they come from and what are they doing now, essentially? I want you to hear it and I want you to do the research and I want you to know it because it'll resonate with who you are. It'll sink down on a deeper level and it will tell your subconscious that it's okay for you to be successful at your age. It's okay for you to be successful in whatever it is you're doing. You know, maybe set up an interview, see if, do you know somebody personally that's been successful in what you're trying to do? Can you talk to them about it and just talk to them, right? They're normal people and realize that they're still normal people because that'll help it settle in that you don't have to change to be successful. You just have to put out the effort. So that's what I want you guys to focus on this week is to really take that time to dive into your success story, to write out your own success story, to redo your beliefs around success, whatever they are, whatever you might think about success. You know, success is hard. Success is for the few. Success is only for men. You know, whatever it is, I want you to write it down, but then I want you to forget about it. And I want you to pay attention to what you have now. And I want you to write out your own success story. And I want you to start working for those things. What can you do every single day to make you feel successful? You know, if I was successful, then I would be taking care of myself. Okay, so what do I need to do today to take care of myself? What is it? Do you need to be working out? Should you be on a certain diet? Should you cut out a certain food? Should you go tanning? Should you be getting massages? Like, I want you guys to really think through those kind of things. And then let me know if you need help with the journaling. Message me. I would prefer if you put it in this group. You can just comment on this video and let me help you with it. Let me help you dive deep into this. But guys, your mindset is a big part of the game. So I'm going to try hard to make sure I'm doing a lot of mindset work for you guys. And I think I'm going to make up my Q&A that I missed on Saturday tomorrow, if that's okay with you guys. So if you have any questions, go ahead and make sure you put them. There's a few already, but please do. Give me some Q&As. And that's it. If you guys have questions, let me know. I really want to help you guys with your mindset. And it starts with learning that you can be successful, knowing it, believing it, getting rid of all the crap you might believe around success and about success. And then we'll just keep diving deeper and deeper and deeper. I think I'm going to spend a couple weeks focusing on money to help you guys really with your money mindset and money mentality. So I hope this is helpful to you guys. Get journaling, get on it, stay with it. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Good night, everyone.